Hello and welcome to Historify. The topic for today's lecture is Jahangir, the Mughal Emperor. Nuruddin Muhammad Salim, known by his imperial name Jahangir, was the fourth Mughal Emperor who ruled from 1605 until his death in 1627. Under this topic, we shall be dealing with some subtopics as to who was Jahangir, what were his conquests about, in particular the conquest of Mewar, the Deccan, Kangra, how he lost Kandahar, and about his illustrious wife Nur Jahan. So talking about Jahangir, Prince Salim, who is later known in history as Jahangir, was born on 31st August 1569 at Fatehpur Sikri to Mughal Emperor Akbar and his wife Mariam-uz-Zamani. Akbar earlier had many children, but none of these children survived and all of them died in infancy. So Akbar sought the blessings of the Sufi saint Khwaja Salim Chishti, and as a result he was blessed and he had a son whom he named Salim. Salim ascended the throne with the title of Nuruddin Muhammad Jahangir Badshah Ghazi, and from here begins the 22-year reign of Jahangir at the age of 36. Jahangir very soon got involved into the chaos that was created by his own son Khusro. Khusro Mirza, however, was defeated in 1606 and confined in the fort of Agra. Jahangir considered his third son, Prince Khurram, that is future Shah Jahan, his favorite and also the heir apparent. Now, when we talk about the conquests of Jahangir, we understand that the conquests of Jahangir were mainly directed to those places which were left unconquered by Akbar, such as Mewar and South India. Jahangir pursued the policy of the extension of his empire like his father, and the conquest of North India was nearly complete during the reign of Akbar. Only a few states, and like Mewar and Rajasthan, were able to maintain their independence. But the conquest of South was absolutely incomplete. So Jahangir tried to not only retain his territory, not only retain the empire that he had inherited from his father, but he also tried to extend the empire into the south of India. Now, when we talk about the Deccan campaigns of Jahangir, we have to talk about Malik Ambar. Malik Ambar, Ahmednagar Rajya ka chief minister tha, and he was proving to be a great force in South India. So what Jahangir did was that he sent an expedition under Prince Khurram, who managed to recapture the fort of Ahmednagar. Prince Khurram was recognized and appreciated for his work, and he was honored with the title of Shah Jahan, which means the Lord of the World. Now, one thing here I would like to mention, Jahangir means the conqueror of the world, while Shah Jahan means the Lord of the World. Now, the war or the differences between Ahmednagar and the Mughal Empire continued. Ahmednagar reasserted its independence and remained outside Mughal control very soon. Now, discussing further, we talk about the conquest of Kangra. After a siege of 14 months, the fort of Kangra, which Akbar had failed to conquer during his lifetime, submitted to the new Mughal emperor, Jahangir. The conquest of Kangra and Mewar gave him great joy because he was able to fulfill Akbar's unrealized imperialistic dreams. Now, we will move on and talk about how Kandahar was lost during the reign of Jahangir. Kandahar in Central Asia was always a bone of contention between the Mughals and the Shah of Persia. Akbar was able to conquer Kandahar from the Shah of Persia. However, after his death, Kandahar could not be retained by the Mughals, and despite of all the efforts that Jahangir had put in, Kandahar was lost. And later on, even Shah Jahan will be spending a lot of time and money over the conquest of Central Asian Mughal provinces, ultimately leading to failure. Here is a picture of Noor Jahan, who was the wife of the Mughal Emperor Jahangir. Noor Jahan's original name was Mehrunnisa, and she was the daughter of Itmat ud-Dawla, who had come to India and started working in the court of the Mughals. Now, after she got married to Emperor Jahangir, Noor Jahan exercised a great deal of influence upon the emperor. She was an accomplished woman. She was very well educated, and the credit of introducing a lot of fashionable clothing and even the production of itr, that is a kind of perfume, goes to Noor Jahan. In fact, Noor Jahan was so powerful and such a woman of grit that she constituted the Noor Jahan Janta, consisting of her father Itmat ud-Dawla, her brother Asif Khan, and Prince Khurram, along with her own self, that this group continued to dominate the politics of the Mughal Empire until 1622. This is the time when Jahangir almost gave the entire authority into the hands of Noor Jahan. Even the coins that were minted during this period carried the picture of Noor Jahan along with the Emperor Jahangir. However, after this, there occurred a breach between Prince Khurram and Noor Jahan, as Noor Jahan started harboring the better interests of her son-in-law Shahryar, while Khurram was already the heir apparent. So there started appearing the differences between the empress and the prince, and as a result of which Prince Khurram rebelled openly between 1622 and 1625. In 1626, Jahangir was temporarily placed under duress by Muhammad Khan, who was also a rival of Noor Jahan. Jahangir, however, died while travelling from Kashmir to Lahore in the year 1627. Now, when we are talking about the reign of Jahangir, it is very important to mention about the contributions he made to art and architecture, especially in the field of painting as an art. The important buildings of the reigns of Jahangir include the tomb of Akbar at Sikandra and the tomb of Itmat ud-Dawla. Jahangir laid the foundation of the famous Shalimar Bagh Garden in Srinagar, and it was during his reign that the red sandstone was replaced by marble of Makarna. Now, he was a very enthusiastic patron of Mughal painting. The beauty of nature in the form of plants, animals and birds became an important subject of Mughal painting during Jahangir's reign. Jahangir promoted calligraphy, which was considered to be the foremost art in the Islamic world. Some of the very famous painters of Akbar and Jahangir's reign include Farrukh Bey, Daswand. Daswand is credited with having painted the Razmnama, that is a Mahabharat, then Basavan, Govardhan, Ustad Mansur, Abul Al Hasan, Bichitra, Bishandas, Miskin. These were some of the very famous painters who were patronized by Akbar and Jahangir, who were great patrons of arts during the Mughal Empire in India. So with this, we come to the end of today's lecturette. Thank you so much.